Hey VC, how's it going? Right, okay, another video showing bits and bobs that I picked up from the Isle of Wight. I've already done one video where I showed some records and some clips of record shops, so if you haven't seen it, you might want to watch that, I don't know. But yeah, so a handful of records and a couple more clips showing some record shops that I visited. So, but first up, not a record shop, a car boot sale. So we're there on a Sunday and I don't know where we're going, but wherever it was, didn't open till 10 o'clock. And there's a car boot just down the road, Chael car boot, I think it was, which I started at 9 o'clock. So I did have a quick wander around there, and there's a guy there selling some records. So first of all, I picked this up. This was certainly the best of the bunch. This is Stiff Little Fingers with Inflammable Materials. Obviously just a classic late 70s punk debut album. I love this record. I've already got two copies of this record. My other copies though are pretty heavily marked, you know, they've clearly been loved over the years, whereas this is a lovely copy. I did pay a tenner for it, but I think it's well worth that. Singles on here, stuff like Suspect Device and Alternative Ulster. Obviously they were a band from Belfast, and obviously a lot of their stuff was about what was going on in Northern Ireland at the time, but there's a lot of stuff on here which is just about being young and being angry and frustrated. You know, a little bit like the Undertones as well, that sort of same deal. But a great record, and I'm sure if you know anything about punk, you'll know that. From the same guy, I also picked this up, Hall of Fame. This is a Georgie Fame compilation, late 60s, just compiling a bunch of his singles. I have a lot of his 45s, but nice to have them all on a comp. Very cool, you know, that sort of cool, groovy Hammond jazz. Yeah, I really like Georgie Fame, so I'll perhaps play a clip from that in a bit. And then I just bought a few blues compilations. These are only £2 each. Now, these are comps which, in the UK, you see around quite a bit, but they're always a bit grubby, and the laminate's always a bit, you know, it's lifted and a bit, you know, a bit skanky or whatever. But, yeah, these are beautiful copies. They cost me £2 each. So, yeah, I picked those up. Very nice. So, really pleased with those. Right, so the first shop I'm going to show a clip from is a shop in Newport in the Isle of Wight called AAA Records. Just a small shop in a little market area. Really like this shop, just jam-packed full of records. Yeah, a bit of an interesting mix of stuff in there. The owner, nice bloke, got chatted to him, you know, decent guy. I did buy one record from him, which was this is obviously the Beatles Magical Mystery Tour on the Horzu label, which was a German label. I learned about this through the VC, because over the years this has been shown by every man and his dog. Meant to be one of the best pressings of this album. Now I already have copies of this. I've got it on CD, I've got it in the mono box, I think. Don't know why it's in there, because it's not a proper album, is it? I don't know, it's an American release, I don't know, but still it's in there. And I've also got the UK EP, you know, the two singles, the EP pack, which is how it came out in the UK. So I don't have an American vinyl pressing of the album to compare this to, but what I will say, it sounds fucking brilliant. So yeah, all the hype is true. So there you go. And finally, one of the shops I went to was called, it was in Shanklin, I think it's called Little Camden Market. Now, a friend put a message on Instagram. He showed that he's been to this store and he picked up some records while he was there. I mentioned I was in the Isle of Wight and he said, check this shop out because there's some good stuff in there. Now, it's only part records. There's a lot of clothes in there as well. It's like an old school market type thing. But some of the records I had in there were very cool. I've taken some footage and I'll show that in a moment. But I bought one record, which is Nina Simone with To Love Somebody. Obviously late 60s, stuff on here such as Turn, 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 Suzanne, obviously the Leonard Cohen song, a great version of that. To Love Somebody, there's stuff like I Shall Be Released, just like Tom Thumb's Blues and The Times That Are Changing, of course all Dylan tunes. But yeah, a lovely record. The only problem with this copy is it's got an edge warp. Now, I don't blame the shop for that. I'm pretty sure they wouldn't have noticed that. I certainly didn't notice when I picked it up, but it does mean that I can't play the first song on either side, which is a total balls because I bought it for her version of Suzanne, which opens up side one. But that aside, it is a lovely copy. It's a lovely lovely sleeve and everything, but I am going to need another copy to sort that out. So there you go, a handful of records from the Isle of Wight, and I'll show a clip of Little Camden Market now. Cheers.